Extreme heat can be very problematic for a lot of succulents. And while most people think of succulents as desert plants, most succulents don't originate from a really hot desert, so they won't survive temperatures well above 100 throughout the summer. I've learned this the hard way in Phoenix, Arizona, where we get temperatures well above 100 degrees Fahrenheit in the summers. In this video, I'm going to share with you 5 succulents that can tolerate that extreme heat and the sunny climate. This is Succulents in Seconds, a quick video with a quick answer to your succulent questions. First up, we have Portulacaria afra. This bushy little succulent actually surprised me at how well it does here in the heat. It forms really nice bushes, or you can also get the trailing variety that will stay low to the ground. Both of these do really well in lots of heat and lots of sun, while still only needing a minimal amount of water. I have found, however, that the variegated variety does not like the heat and sun as much as its purely green counterpart. A classic succulent for heat and sun is the golden barrel cactus. Its beautiful yellow spines protect that flesh of the cactus and prevent it from burning in direct sunlight. It also stores an incredible amount of water in its beautiful rounded form, so it can go long periods of time without water. You'll also find that its long spines don't leave slivers in your fingers, so it's a little bit safer option if you have kids or pets, or if you're just opposed to cactus and the risk of being injured. The blue-gray color of Agave parryi is subtle but stunning. It also has a really nice black highlight right along the tips that highlights those sharp points along the edges. The rest of it, though, has really beautiful, smooth leaves, which is a nice contrast from most of the cactus that you would see in a hot desert climate. You'll also find that once established, this succulent loves the heat and the sun and can go for long periods of time without water. The blue tones provide a nice contrast to the dirt or soil that tend to be around it, which are usually orange or red. Euphorbia tirucalli sticks on fire loves the heat and the sun. It shows off its love for the sun by turning a flaming red and orange at the top. It can grow into really big bushes, or you can keep it pruned and smaller. Just make sure that when you're pruning, you pay attention to that milky sap and avoid letting it get in contact with your skin or eyes, as it can be irritating. And of course, we can't talk about heat-loving succulents without mentioning Opuntias. One of my favorites is Opuntia macrocentra. It has a really beautiful purple bluish tone, and it gets these really long black spines. In the spring, it also gets a really soft rose-like yellow flower that complements the purple hues nicely. This succulent does well in lots of sun and lots of heat, and it will survive even cold winters as well. As I mentioned, these succulents grow really well in heat and sun, but most other succulents won't. I found out the hard way that even echeverias do not like the hot sun, even if they're in the shade. On the other hand, aloes and agaves tend to do really well if they have a good established root system. You can let them go for long periods of time without water, and they will still thrive under the hot desert sun. It's so important to choose succulents that grow well for the area you live in. Otherwise, you'll find yourself with constantly dying succulents or ones that just don't look great. If you'd like to learn more about what kinds of succulents will work for you and where you live, be sure to visit typesofsucculents.com. Thanks so much for watching. If you liked this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe, and share it with all of your succulent-loving friends, and I will see you next time.